Children, we are ready to start with the demonstration of preparing sodium carbonate extract. You can see sir has placed a beaker containing water to which he is adding 1 spoon of
magnesium sulfate
salt, and to this we are going to add in the ratio of 1:3 the 3 spoons of sodium carbonate. This sodium carbonate, when it is mixed with the salt and it is boiled for some time, then the sodium carbonate extract will be prepared. According to the theory, you must know that in this reaction that is taking place, the cations will get converted into the carbonates and the anions will be obtained as soluble sodium salts in the filtrate. So we will wait while this is being boiled. This has to be boiled for about a good 5 to 10 minutes. So it is being boiled there, and let us wait till the reaction takes place. Now you can see, children, the solution is turning turbid, which means that the carbonate salt of the cation, which is insoluble, is seen as the white turbidity, and the anion is going to combine with sodium to form a soluble sodium sulfate. So we will, this has been almost 10 minutes we have been boiling the solution, and we will now filter the solution to obtain the filtrate and the precipitate. The filtrate that will be obtained will be used for testing the anions after acidifying it. The precipitate that will be obtained will be used for testing the cations after preparing a suitable original solution for the cation. For the anion, we need to acidify because we have mixed it with a good amount of sodium carbonate and the solution is alkaline in nature. So to provide a neutral medium, it has to be acidified before testing for the anions. You can see now that the hot solution will be filtered so that the filtrate and the precipitate can be obtained separately. You can see in the filtrate, clear solution is being obtained. This clear solution is containing the anion of the salt that we have taken for analysis. And in the filter paper, when the solution is poured on the filter paper, precipitate of the carbonate of the cation will be formed. So sir, we'll have to wait till the solution is cooled before proceeding for the tests. Now this filtrate that we have obtained, we will be using it in different amounts, separate amounts, to test for the different anions. Now you can see, children, this is the precipitate we got in the on the filter paper. Now this will be collected for the analysis of the cation that is present in the salt. So you can see sir is trying to take it from the filter paper, and a good amount of the precipitate was obtained, which is actually analyzed for the cations for the group analysis, the systematic analysis that has been taught to you all in the class. So now you can see sir has taken that cooled solution from the conical flask into the test tube. Sir, if you can show the solution. See, the solution is there. Now this solution is the filtrate, a part of the filtrate that we collected. Now to this sir is going to add any acid. Now since we are going to first test for the sulfate radical, we will not add sulfuric acid. Other than sulfuric acid, we will add any other acid. I think sir is going to take acetic acid, which is available right in front. So a little amount of acetic acid will be added to neutralize the effect of the base due to the extra sodium carbonate that was present. So that has been acidified. And now the test for the sulfate radical is to add barium chloride solution when a dense white precipitate will be obtained, which will be insoluble in any other acid, that any inorganic acid. So that is barium chloride solution, sir. And we are adding without shaking. See the dense white precipitate that we got. This dense white precipitate, since the medium is already acidic, we can understand that in this case it is not soluble in the acid also. This is the confirmatory test for the sulfate radical. So even after pouring a little amount of HCl, we will see it is not soluble. So we can now say that the salt that we had taken to prepare the sodium carbonate contains the sulfate radical. So now this is another part of the filtrate. It is not from the same one, because we have prepared a sodium carbonate extract again for the other salt, and the solution we have obtained as the filtrate from that. And in this case we are going to test for the chloride ion. Okay, sir. Okay. Sir, so what are the reagents for the chloride ion?
Silver nitrate solution,
which is always available on the bench. And to this, again, this has been acidified, children, so you have to remember that it is the acidified sodium carbonate filtrate, to which sir is adding AgNO3. From the bottle you can make out it is AgNO3. You see, again there is a formation of a white precipitate. This white precipitate that has been formed can be further confirmed to be a chloride, because when we add excess of ammonium hydroxide, you can note the change that is taking place.
Let me throw half.
Okay, sir. So this is the chemistry lab, children. You can have a look at it. So sir has reduced the portion so that the solubility can be seen. And you see, upon adding excess of ammonium hydroxide, it is going to dissolve. And therefore, the chloride ion has been confirmed in this particular salt. So what we are doing in this video is showing you how to test the anions in the salt by preparing the sodium carbonate filter. Okay, children, now we are going to test another salt, and this time we are going to test for the nitrate ion. Again, the sodium carbonate filtrate has been acidified by an acid other than nitric acid, and to test for the nitrate ion we need freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution, which has been prepared in this test tube. And the test is to add freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution in almost equal amount to the salt solution, and it has been added. This is actually the sodium carbonate filtrate, and to this, in a slanting position, concentrated sulfuric acid will be added, when we will be able to see a brown ring forming at the junction of the two liquids. So let us see what happens. Very carefully, sir, you are not using a holder. Very carefully, it will be allowed to trickle down. And you see, since sulfuric acid is heavy, it will go and settle at the bottom. And more of the acid, I think, we need to add, sir. Very carefully, you have to be very careful in this addition of sulfuric acid along the walls. Okay, yes, that is the brown ring that we are talking about. And you can see a brown ring, very clear brown ring has been formed at the junction of the two liquids. That is, sulfuric acid being denser is forming the bottom layer, and the ferrous sulfate and the salt solution are forming the upper layer. Once this brown ring has been formed, you can concentrate, I mean, you can very clearly say that the salt contains the nitrate ion. So this is the brown ring that we can see. The brown ring can be seen very clearly, and that is it. Okay, children, now the another anion that we will do is for the carbonate radical. Now again, we have taken another salt which is containing the carbonate radical, and the test for the carbonate radical is that you don't have to use the filtrate for this, because in the sodium carbonate filtrate we have added carbonate ourselves only. So dry salt is taken in a dry test tube, to this acid is added. So you can see that sir is going to add the acid. So HCl is being added, children, You can see it is, I think, hydrochloric acid that sir is adding. Upon adding, immediately there is effervescence and the gas evolved will be passed into the lime water, because this is the lime water test we are going to do. So you can see the gas is up. Evolved gas is being bubbled into this,
and that turned milky.
And see, it is turning milky. If you see, it is turning milky. This milkiness that is appearing is due to the evolution of carbon dioxide gas in the test tube where the HCl and the carbonate salt were mixed. So this is how we can confirm the presence of you can see the milkiness very clearly. This is how you can confirm the formation, the presence of carbonate radical in a salt. You see the milkiness. You can see the milkiness appearing very clearly. Okay, so this is indicating that it is the carbonate ion present in the salt. Right, children. So with this, we will end the video where we are demonstrating the identification of the anions. However, the acetate ion is left, sir. Acetate ion, we have to test it with that fruity smell of ester. So maybe in one of the salts we can take and do it. Sir, if you can explain the test, what is to be done?
A simple test can be done for acetate radical. The soda extract of acetate we collect, and in them we add ferric chloride solution. We get brown precipitation, and this is what confirmatory test for acetate radical
is. Okay, sir.
Thank you,
sir, for the demo. Thank you, children, for being there. And with this, we come to the end of this video where we are showing the identification of the acid radical for a salt. Okay, children, and now you will see that the precipitate that was obtained in the sodium carbonate extract preparation, that filtrate is containing the carbonate radical, and obviously the original solution is prepared by adding dilute HCl to the precipitate obtained. So sir is adding HCl to obtain the original solution, and this original solution is then, it is he's shaking it to dissolve it completely, and this original solution will then be taken in small parts to be tested for group 1, group 2, group 3 by using the suitable reagents. And as you can see that the clear solution has been obtained. Now we will take a small portion, sir, and to this we are adding dilute HCl, which is a reagent for group 1, and you can see that it is not forming any precipitate. Into this solution, when H2S is bubbled, then also it did not form any precipitate. The Kipps apparatus has been kept on the other side, so after bubbling also it did not form any precipitate. So we'll discard this solution, and we will now perform the test for the group 3 radical. Now for group 3 radical, again we will be taking a fresh portion of that solution, to which a little ammonium chloride will be added and ammonium hydroxide. Here the common ion effect will come into play, and the required amount of the hydroxide ions will be obtained. So sir is adding a pinch of ammonium chloride. Just a small pinch is required, that is all. Upon shaking, it dissolves, and to this, when we are adding ammonium hydroxide, we should not get any precipitate. You can see ammonium hydroxide is being added. So it's a clear solution and no precipitate obtained. So this indicates that group 3 is also absent. Now in the same solution, when H2S was bubbled, no precipitate was seen, and you see even after bubbling H2S, no precipitate was obtained, so group 4 is also absent. Wait. So now we are taking a fresh portion of that filtrate, and into this sir is going to add group 5 we are performing. So ammonium chloride, ammonium hydroxide and ammonium carbonate. So ammonium hydroxide added, sir?
No, I'm adding. No. Ammonium hydroxide.
And to this ammonium carbonate is added. Again, you see there is no precipitate obtained. So we can very conveniently say that group 5 is also absent, sir. Cations of group 5 are
absent.
Barium, strontium and calcium, all the three are absent. So now with the filtrate of this, we have to proceed for the next group. Okay, for the group 6, in which you only have to do magnesium, the filtrate of the group 5 is actually taken, and to this a little ammonium hydroxide is added, and to this the phosphate radical will be added for testing the magnesium. There is no particular group reagent for group 6, but the test for the magnesium radical will be tested, and so for this any phosphate radical actually will help. So here we are taking sodium phosphate, and sir is adding the phosphate because it is deliquescent, it has become slightly liquidy in nature. And after this, upon shaking you can see the precipitate is being formed. When you scratch the walls of the test tube, you can see the precipitate being formed. So you can see that the white precipitate has been obtained. This white precipitate that is obtained, if it does not come so easily, you need to scratch the inner walls of the test tube with a glass rod when the precipitate can be obtained. So this confirms group 6 magnesium ions confirmed. Yes, sir. And only magnesium ions they have to do in standard 12?
Yes.
So with this, the cation magnesium has been confirmed. Okay, sir. So with this, we come to the end of this today's video, and the other cations we will be showing in the subsequent videos. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.